But first tonight, the long and painful road to justice is finally over for the heartbroken family of a baby, Skye Sassine, killed in a crash with a crazed criminal driver. He was trying to outrun police at the time after a long crime spree. Today, even the judge admitted he was shocked by the case as he threw the book at him.
2.5 years after he cradled his dying daughter Skye in his arms, Justin Wright went public to applaud the maximum 19-year jail term slapped on her killer.
We are happy with the sentence. It's the best we could have hoped for. It's never going to be enough. Never would. Nothing's going to bring Skye back. But hopefully now we can have some closure on the matter.
19-month-old Skye was killed when armed robber William Nagati ploughed into the family car while being chased by police. It led to tough new laws.
It means a lot to me because I refuse since day one to let her death go in vain. I'll represent my daughter till my last breath. Skye's law is there to ensure this doesn't happen to another family.
In sentencing today, the judge said Nagati he was well aware to at least the possibility of maiming or killing others. For 15 minutes, he sped up to 100 kilometres above the limit. Many motorists were nearly hit as he ran red lights, through stop signs, then onto the wrong side of the Hume Highway in heavy traffic. His actions resulted in the father holding the dying child in his arms.
William Nagati knows these courthouses well. The judge said his criminal record was too long to list, but it included facing charges of stalking, robbery, assault, drug supply and intimidation.
Nagati insists Skye's death was a tragic accident. Her parents and the courts disagree.
We see her every single weekend and there's never a second she's not on our mind or far from our thoughts at all. She's always going to be with us.
Especially tomorrow, it would have been Skye's 4th birthday. Ali Donaldson, 10 News.